boys, with a real super welcome for our hostess, Tammy Sue Bakker.
Hello. Is my mic on? Hello. Okay. How's everybody today? Today is Country Day or Western Day or whatever you want to call it kind of day. Can you tell?
No.
See all these people out here with these hats on? Everybody wave at the camera. Yay!
Hey, Tammy Sue, this looks like a real heyday.
I know it. Well, I got Doug Oldham.
Yay!
Yeah. Yay! Hey.
As my co-host.
Thank you.
My co-host. Come on, Doug. You can come up.
I'm going to
stand?
Yeah,
you're going to stand.
Oh, boy.
You're supposed to walk up.
I ain't never done this before.
And we have some special guests with us today.
Oh, do we ever have special guests?
We have Dennis A. Hi, Dennis. And he can pronounce his name, his last name.
Oh, it's Agaginian. I can do that because of the racing Agaginians. They were racing all over Indiana when I was coming on and still racing well, as
racing,
I understand.
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Great.
And we have, who else do we have here today with us?
Well, we've got Richard Dortch. He doesn't look like he's a Westerner. He might pass as the district superintendent in Wyoming with the black boots and that sort of thing. Bob and Jeannie Johnson, of course, are on the set. Jeannie and Bob are going to sing after a while, and Henry Harrison is here. Henry?
Yeah.
I wish, honey, you could find a red shirt someday.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little... it worries me. You're so subdued all the time.
If I could find one, I'd
get. And then we've got these fabulous PTL singers. And,
yeah.
Yay! Yay!
And we also have the president of J&J Music.
Yes, Jerry is here. I don't know where, but Jerry is here.
Great.
And we have...
Well,
we watched him last night.
When I turned around to look at Jerry sitting back there, right in front of him is, I think, probably the most foremost, and I've said this two or three times, Steve, in your absence, I think he probably is the premier spokesman for gospel music among male vocalists. Steve Green is in the audience today. And by the way, we want to get back to Steve in just a minute, but before we do, I want to thank you for calling and for the cards you've been sending to Tammy out there at Rancho Mirage at Eisenhower. The phones have been ringing off the hook out there and here as well, and we appreciate your phone calls. We need to update you because not all of you are able to watch every day, and we need to bring you up to date as to Tammy Faye's condition. I think most of you know that shortly after Christmas, Tammy became very ill with the flu while on vacation up in the mountains of Tennessee. And we thought, you know, that rest and just the common medication for flu would get her over in a hurry because she bounces back very quickly. But she didn't bounce back as well as we had hoped this time. And she ended up with not just the flu, but she went into pneumonia. And her temperature went to 103, and with that temperature going up and the medication she was taking, she even got into hallucination. And we had a doctor friend of ours, Lester Nichols, came out to see her and immediately ordered a plane. We flew her to California, where she was met by the doctors from Eisenhower, and she didn't even go home. She went directly to the hospital, has been there ever since. She was flown by private plane out there to Eisenhower at Rancho Mirage in California. She was admitted upon arrival, as I mentioned, and she's had great care. And if you have to go to hospital, go to Eisenhower Hospital. Laura and I had both of our surgeries there this past summer. It's got to be one of the finest staffs of people you've ever run into in your life. And her pneumonia is still there, and it looks like she's in for at least a 4-week, maybe a 6-week siege. We're just not getting the results we need. And Jim and Tam want to thank you, as we do, for all the cards and flowers that you've sent out there. And yesterday, Tammy had some inhalation therapy, and she was having a problem with her breathing. She had the therapy, and it was not an easy therapy for her, but she's holding her own, and we appreciate your prayers, and hope that you will continue to pray. And please send cards. You can send them to Eisenhower Hospital, Rancho Mirage, California, or you can send them here, because every day, everything that comes in here is expressed to Tammy Faye. We send it out to her, and she said, Jim was talking to us on the phone just before the program, and he said Tammy Faye said that she felt and has felt more love in this period of time than she's ever felt in her life. And I want to thank you, because she needs love, and she needs your prayers. So does Jim. And we've got a thing happening here that I when you get to Christmas City, I don't know, you can't wait for it to get here. You hate to see it end, and it's coming to an end. And
that's right.
It's your turn.
My turn.
Yes.
Two more weeks of Christmas City, right?
Right.
And we have a final look at Christmas City. It's called a VTR, not a VCR. And we're going to watch this now. So here we go. Thank you. Yeah. You got to remember, there's only 2 weeks left of Christmas City, so you have to come see it now. You have to wait 6 months.
I hope we can have Christmas year-round someday. I love the lights. I like them when I come in in the evening, and I love it when I finish at the end of the day.
Yes, but you cannot say that you like the Christmas City traffic.
You could have talked all day and not said that. However, this is the time to see the lights, right?
Yes,
because the lines are not nearly as long as they are before Christmas and New Year's.
That's right.
And I hope you'll take advantage of it and come see Christmas City.
Yes. Well, we have our special guest that we're going to talk to in the audience with us right now, don't we?
Yeah, and I wasn't supposed to introduce him, but when I looked up here, I got excited. Greg, Greg Nelson sitting beside him arranges for Sandy Patty and Steve Green. And Jerry, J&J Music, what, one of the largest music conventions in the country, isn't it?
I ought to give you a microphone.
Oh, that's all right. Yes, sir. We have about 400 ministers of music here this week, and from churches all over the United States, Canada, and we're having a great time being right here at PTL and enjoying Christmas City. It has been marvelous.
Great. There are three great concerts left. Last night, Steve Green was here in concert, and tonight, and tomorrow night, and Thursday night, will you tell the people who your guests are?
Tonight we have Carla Worley. Carla has just started a solo career. She is the first soprano backup singer for the Bill Gaither Trio and just does a phenomenal job. She replaced Sandy Petty. When you have to replace her, you're bound to be pretty good. Mm. And then tomorrow night we have the Cathedral Quartet.
Yeah.
And then, they're going to be good. And then Thursday night, one of my favorite groups in the world, Truth, will be here. Roger Bremen and Truth will be here Thursday night.
Thank you. Those concerts are at
8 o'clock.
And you can come. There's no admission charge. J&J Music does that as their gift to you. So I hope you'll plan to be here. And tomorrow morning, the Imperials will be your guests.
The
Cathedrals. Yes. Excuse me. The Cathedrals. And they do flat out sing.
They do.
Steve, I need to get back to you because I know you got a plane to catch. I appreciate your coming in. And I like your philosophy of music. First of all, I like your music. Secondly, I just like you. I've only been with you once or twice, but I have found you to be a very gentle soul. And with great talent, you don't always find gentility. And I appreciate it. If you had to boil it down to one thing, what do you think is the most important thing for a gospel singer?
Well, obviously, talent. Talent is something important because we're in the business of communicating. But even more than that, there has to be something to communicate. And that's often the part that's left out because that's what takes time. There's no way to have instant maturity and instantly something inside to share. But as we live with the Lord and spend time with him, and it's an act of the will, and it's Christian disciplines, it's obedience. And then somehow God, by his mercy, begins to grow us up on the inside, and that's really what will come out. Otherwise, we might be a flash in the pan, but if our lives are grounded in the Word, and if Christ really is Lord, and we live and we exist in him, then the music is a wonderful means to communicate that life in Christ.
I agree with you 100%. And why don't you introduce your song? I can introduce it. But why don't you introduce your song?
All right.
And Susan, I'll go that way, and you can go that way.
I'll do it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This was written by a dear friend named Phil McHugh, and it's so simple. The lyrics are simple and sometimes maybe even a little repetitive, but it reminds us again that all the glory and everything we are and everything we do belongs to God and God alone.
Alone, God and God. God alone reveals the truth of all we call unknown. And all the best and worst of man won't change the master's plan. It's God's and God's alone. God and God alone is fit to take the universe's throne. Let everything that lives reserve.
Thank you for staying and singing that for us. You are wonderful. That was just great.
And Greg Nelson and Scott Wesley Brown, I think, wrote the tune. Phil McHugh, you gave me bad information. Good, that's all right. I don't blame you. You and I are both green with envy.
Oh.
If I could just do that one time before I die, I not going to say I'd pass up heaven. I wouldn't pass up heaven, but it sure would be a temptation. I mean,
that's
that
wonderful.
Is such a tremendous voice. Tremendous voice.
Great talent.
It really is.
Richard?
Yes.
You're sitting over there looking so dignified, but I notice next to you, you have the white book. And for those of you who tuned in late, we talked at the opening of the program about Jim and Tammy Faye. And, I tried to update you a little bit on Tammy Faye's condition. She is at Eisenhower out there in Rancho Mirage, California. And by the way, may we ask you please not to call the hospital. Don't call the hospital. You can send cards out there, but their switchboards aren't equipped as well as ours to handle that deluge of calls. And it complicates things for them if you call. But she had her inhalation therapy yesterday. It was a very difficult process for her, but she's holding her own. The pneumonia seems to be just kind of balancing where it is. We have not seen the recovery that we would like to see.
But one of the things that will be weighing heavily on her mind and on Jim's mind as they go through this time is the survival of the ministry that they have built over these years here at PTL. And you can help us. Richard had a great idea yesterday. He was talking about an army of people. We have 88,000 of these beautiful white books that explain the ministry of Heritage Village Church. And if we could have 88,000 people who would send $100 during this period of Jim and Tammy's having to be gone from us, it would keep the old ship afloat and help us to continue the ministries as they are. We won't have to curtail anything. It would just absolutely be a blessing to Jim and Tammy both. And Richard has that book over there, and I happen to know that he loves it because he spent so many hours in getting it put together.
Doug, to me it boils down simply to this, that if Jim and Tammy Bakker could today come and sit down at your house, let's just suppose for a moment that Jim and Tammy would come and sit down with you in your living room and look you in the eye and simply say, if you had helped me now, if you'd become one of the 88,000, we'll have no worries, this ministry is going to make it. Now think of that. If Jim and Tammy could just sit down with you for a moment today in your house and simply say, if you'd become one of 88,000 people, that will take care of the needs, and PTL will be strong, and your lifetime membership and your regular monthly support for this ministry, it's going to be sufficient. You know what I think you'd do? I think that today you'd look at Jim and Tammy Bakker and say, Jim and Tammy, you can depend on me.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
No question. You can depend on me. I've been through a lot of things with you. I've prayed for you when you've come through tough times, but you can count on me now. I believe that you would do that. I really do.
Amen.
And that's what we're doing today. We're simply saying to you, Doug Oldham and I are simply saying to you, Tammy Sue is saying to you, all of us, that if you become one of 88,000 people, if you'll join this army, we can know that PTL, during these difficult times for Jim and Tammy, Jim and Tammy, don't worry about the ministry during these days. Just get well. We're praying for you.
Amen.
We don't want anything else to bother you. We want to stand with you. Now, if that takes place, if Jim and Tammy, because they're coming to your house every day, that's the point. They're coming to your house 24 hours a day on the network. They're coming to you every day through this visit. All the needs will be taken care of. And for your gift of $100, we want to send you this magnificent book that answers the question, what is PTL? What's the Heritage Village Church? What's Heritage USA? It answers all those questions. And you'll see the pictures of the upper room. Many of you have wanted to get here and you haven't gotten here yet, the upper room. You'll see pictures of the Heritage Grand. There's Art, our loving, friendly, praying doorman. It's a fabulous book. The beautiful countryside. There are just so many wonderful things. There's Tammy Faye and Tammy Sue and all the guests. And this book will answer the question for you. So what about this visit today? Jim and Tammy are saying to you, will you help us? So if you'll go to your telephone now and call, will you do that? Will you right now go to your telephone, call, you can use your American Express card, your Visa card, your MasterCard, and call 704-554-6000. Or write to Jim Bakker, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28279. Doug, I believe that this visit today and all the visits along the line, people are going to say, if that's what it takes to keep this ministry strong during this time of illness, we're going to stand with you.
Well, we had a lot of calls yesterday, and I know they're going to call today. And I'd like to have prayer for Tammy Faye and for the others who are watching, who are hurting today. And if you want to pray for Tammy Faye, I'm not sure. And the noise you just heard was a light going, and so
reminds me.
We'll just. Dennis thought somebody was after him there.
Yeah.
I think one of the best ways you can say to Tammy Faye, we want you to get well, is to pick up your phone.
Yes.
And to dial that number, 704-554-6000. And when you write today, when you send your card, you don't call, when you send your card, put your check in there. Mark it for the ministry book. Mail that check to Heritage. Send your card of greeting to Tammy Faye. We'll send it out tomorrow. Heavenly Father,
yes, Lord.
We pray for Tammy Faye today.
Yes.
and for Jim. I miss them so much because they are such a part of my life. And I know our friends and partners who look in miss them because they're part of their lives. There are a lot of people out there who hurt today. A lot of people with pneumonia.
Yes.
A lot of people who, like Jim, didn't sleep all night. They don't have anybody to call at 5:30 in the morning. Their friends are few, and they're lonely. We pray that they'll feel the love that Tammy and Jim have felt. We pray that somebody will think and take time to call them, to drop them a card. But most of all, we pray that thy spirit will permeate the room where they're lying, that they will feel the touch of thy divine presence on their bodies. Be with those who care for them. For some of them, it's been a long time, a long siege. We pray, Lord, that you'll renew their strength, their vitality, that they will make that caring a gift to you and realize that every time they carry in a cup of cold water, they've really done what you have asked us to do, and that it goes in thy name. Touch our partners and our friends. Be with them as you're with Tammy Faye and with Jim this day. And we'll praise your name for that which happens in each of our lives. And if you have a need, why don't you let us know about it? We want you to write for the ministry book. We want you to call for the ministry book. But we also want to say to you, hey, we care. Pick up your phone, dial that same number, 704-554-6000. Leave your prayer request. Put it in the mail. Send it to Jim Bakker, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28279. We want to hear from you today. We want to pray for you. And we need you to pray for us.
Well, we have Bob and Jeannie.
I hope, can you see her eyes? She bubbles. It scares me. I turn around and I see a little bit of Tammy Faye in her, and there's enough Tammy Sue that I never know exactly what's coming. What is coming, child? Lay it on me.
Nothing. Just Bob and Jeannie.
Oh, well, that's great. Hey, that's more than nothing.
I meant nothing.
I know what you meant.
Nothing going on. I mean, nothing that, like a horse not going to walk
We're
out.
We're in trouble.
Or,
what do you mean a horse is not going
like
to walk?
That.
You never know on this show.
Well, no, you don't. I mean, if I could have, we could have had.
How about a giraffe?
Yeah, giraffe. And barnyard animals and chickens. But we just couldn't work that out. But we can work it out for Bob and Jeannie to sing for us today, and they're going to sing Lay Down the Burden of Your Heart.
Yeah. Good song for today. Good song for today.
That will walk you through, lay down the burdens of your heart. But it's worn and touched, walking two by two, lay down the burden of your heart. Lay down the burden of your heart.
Yeah.
Great. Right. Yeah. Okay. Oh, we got talent.
Good singing.
That was great.
I love it. I don't know why. Every time I hear them sing, I love it. I know what they've been through.
Hallelujah.
I know what they've been through. Isn't it funny when God digs you out of a hole? It seems like the deeper the hole, the higher he raises you on the other side.
That's right.
I'd love to hear those kids sing.
How are y'all doing today?
Good.
Y'all got your animals with you?
You bet.
They've got their barnyard animals with them here today.
Our critters. Oh.
Don't upset me.
He's
got a hyperactive tail over here. That you
well, we have Dennis A with us. I don't want to attempt his name because I'm afraid I'm going to mess up.
Tammy S. Dennis Agajanian.
Agajanian. Right. Oh, I said it.
Good. Yeah.
All right. And I'm going to give his album a plug because, see, if it was me on somebody's show, I would want them to show my album
that.
So they sell more. And this has only been out how long?
It's been out about 3 weeks.
About 3 weeks.
On Word Records. And I'm real excited about it.
And it's called Friendly Fire. Oh, there we go. Friendly Fire.
And it's got a lot of classical songs. And country, outlaw, little bit of contemporary, little bit of rock and roll, but classical music too. I mean, I'm doing all kinds
something
of crazy
something for everybody.
Things. I like to wear a suit now and then and play, you know, songs
I've
like...
I've never seen you in a suit.
You know, songs like...
Yeah, all right.
Kind of
like
classical. Wear a suit, no hat. And then I like to, you know...
I've never seen you without the hat, and I've never seen you in a suit.
I look like a biker, man. But hey... Hey, you know, I'm not good looking, but I got a personality, you know what I mean? I mean, you know, I don't have a lot here, but I got it here, you know what I mean? Hair doesn't grow on steel. I don't get the foof over, you know, some guys have the big full foof over, goes woo, like that. And, I just
and then it covers everything.
Franklin
out,
Graham
right.
told me, so just comb it back, man, and
be cool.
Be kind of a biker, you know. Yeah.
Well, we'll have to talk back to the singers now, because y'all are going to sing a song for us.
We are.
Aren't y'all going to sing a song for us?
Yeah, we are.
This song is called Excuses.
We are.
And I think we're going to have to think of excuses for not singing the song, huh? Okay, come on.
Excuses, you'll hear them every day. Oh, the devil is a blinder if the church is stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers those excuses.
Well, in the summer it's too hot. Well, and in the winter, well, it's too cold. And in the springtime, when the weather's just fine, well, you find someplace else to go. What's either up to the mountain, or down to the beach, or to visit some old friend, or just to stay at home and kind of relax and just hope the kids won't come dropping in.
Well, those church benches are too hard, and that choir sings way too loud. And you know how it makes you kind of nervous when you're sitting in a great big crowd? Well, the doctor says you better stay away from them crowds, because they'll always set you back. But now you go down to that old baseball game, because there's where you can relax.
Yeah, he got a headache on Sunday morning, and then he got a backache Sunday night. But friend, when Monday morning comes rolling around, you're feeling quite all right. You know what? One of my youngins, she has a cold. Pneumonia, do you suppose?
Well, the whole family had to stay home.
Just to blow the poor kid's nose.
Excuses, you'll hear them every day. Oh, the devil, he'll supply them. In the church, you'll stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers those excuses.
Well, the preacher, he's too young.
What?
But then again, maybe he's too old. His sermons, they're not hard enough. But then again, they're way too bold. His speech is much too quiet. But then again, he's way too loud. He ought to have more confidence. Then again, he's way too proud.
Well, the sermons, they're too long. Or maybe they're too short. He ought to preach the word with dignity instead of stomping and snorting. Well, that preacher, he must be one of the world's most stuck-up men. Why, one of the ladies in church told me the other day,
he didn't even shake my hand.
Excuses, excuses, you'll hear them every day. Oh, the devil, he'll supply them if the church will stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers those excuses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers those
fun doing that.
Hey.
We were being bad back here.
We were.
We were just being bad, getting the guys, you know, suspenders and going snap, snap.
How anybody can remember lyrics with that going on in the back of my mind, never know.
Your shirt's on fire, better pull it out. Pull it out.
Dennis Agadinian. The first time I remember anything about you, I was sitting in the coffee shop. I can't remember where the crusade was with
Billy Graham?
Cliff Barrows. I was sitting there with Cliff. It was a Graham crusade.
Uh-huh.
And Cliff, you had just come out of, I think, New York.
Yeah.
And he said, do you know Dennis Agadinian? And I was thrilled to say, no. No. But I said, no. He said, if you ever need a man to work the streets, Dennis Agadinian is the greatest man in the streets I've ever seen. He said, when you hit the streets of New York, he said, people listened.
Well, I think that instead of talking, especially with a lot of young people, I'm sure you can relate to this. You know, we look at young people who are on drugs today. They're drinking a lot. They're messing around. And what we're trying to do is moralize the world. And you're never going to moralize the world. You got to change a person's heart first. And when you change a person's heart, everything else will take place. I mean, you get a person smoking cigarettes and doing all these things. Get off of the cigarettes. Get off of the whiskey, you know. I mean, don't preach that. Preach Christ. Let the guy's heart change. Everything else is going to change once he's come to a saving knowledge of Christ.
Amen.
And when they listen to that, and you don't really preach about the sin people involved. In fact, I've gone to some homosexual marches, and I've stood there, and I've said, talking about Christ only, not talking about, well, you guys are homosexuals, you're doing this and that. Just saying, Jesus Christ said this, and what we need to do is get our life right with him. We need to start following him. We need to be bold for him. They've applauded me. They've said, hey, thank you. That's what they need. Get their heart changed, and everything else, God will fall in the place.
And God loves them. He doesn't love their acts, but he loves them.
He doesn't
them.
Love their acts at all, but he's made a way for them to find hope. And there's nothing I've ever done to deserve heaven. There's nothing Tammy Sue or Jim Bakker or any of us have ever done to deserve heaven. When we die, we should never claim justice. We should just claim the blood of Christ. That's all we have. Yeah. We have nothing else, you know, but that.
And have you got something real short? I'd like for you to do something real short and showy on the guitar.
Real short
just,
here.
I mean, if this won't catch the attention of anybody anywhere, then they don't like music or they're dead.
I don't think you do it in your typical church Sunday morning service. You know, I do classical music, but this is a song a lot of times when I'm playing to younger people that's kind of a finger calisthenic. It's called the Foggy Mountain Breakdown. They wanted me to do it with all this hay here and horses and cowboy hats. And by the way, men, you got to wear your hat down. You can't wear it like this hot. You got kind of a, you know, kind of a man thing and lift it. You know, kind of like hers. That's cool.
She knows how. And he's also known as the fastest guitar in the West. I don't know anybody that can equal.
I got to get away, so no, I don't have any suspenders. They're not going to pull.
Oh, we'll find something.
This is a neat crowd. Let's give a hand for the crowd being here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
you. I'd like to say that it's a real honor to be able to be on this program, and I certainly hope that you pray for Tammy Sue, and you pray again for Jim, and the work that they're doing. They support people like you wouldn't believe. I work with Samaritan's Purse and World Medical Missions, and they have built hospitals. They have built facilities all over the country for third world people. And I've had the opportunity of being in Beirut, Lebanon, and with Franklin Graham, and being in Nicaragua, and Cambodia, and Malaysia, and we're going to the Soviet Union, I hope, this year. And when I come back, you know, I don't care what people have ever done in their life, what sin they've ever done, you can't unscramble eggs. You got to press on. And realize that Jesus Christ wants us to be the loving people that he's called us to be. To go into the world and love not one another by word of tongue, but deed and truth. He told her goodbye. Then he walked out the door. She started to cry. She knew she wouldn't see him anymore. Instead of falling apart, she just knelt down to pray. She knew in her heart, love has a way. He's a sad little boy, growing up all alone. His mom's working nights since his daddy left home. They can make a new start if he'd come home to stay. In this little boy's heart, love has a way. When you think there's no hope, love has a way. When you think you can't cope, love has a way. When your life falls apart, love has a way. Where there's a tougher than nails, nails they drove in his hand. His love never fails, and he still understands all the heartache and pain people face every day. Jesus is love. His love has a way. When you think there's no hope, love has a way. When you think you can't cope, love has a way. When your life falls apart, a heart, you very much. I love you all. It does, you know, regardless of what you do.
Love has a way.
It has a way.
I can't get over, by the way, those of you who are tuned in late, you wonder where Jimmy and Tammy are. They're in California. Tam's in the hospital out there at Eisenhower, and she's not having a good time. The pneumonia still has a strong hold on her body. We do have a Tammy here, however. A very pretty young Tammy. And it's fun for me because I love this kid. She is more fun. And I get a, oh, ho, ho, yourself, ho, ho, ho. We have a grand time, and it is nice to see her mature and fight. Did you realize that, what, this is your fourth program?
Fourth. Yes, the fourth one.
And love does have a way. Her love reaches through to you.
That's right.
Your love reaches out there to California. I wanted one more verse, Dennis. I wanted that husband to come home.
You know, I was in Nashville at Word Records. This album just came out a couple weeks ago, and people came up with their songs, and they said, well, here's a song I want you to hear, you know.
Oh, yeah.
How are you?
Oh,
and
boy.
I'm fine, thank you very much. And they played it, and they said, well, God wrote this song. I'm saying, honey, God don't write bad music, you know. That song is terrible, man. And then the secretary came up and she said, well, your plane leaves in an hour, and there's this one more guy downstairs, you know, and he's got an old t-shirt on, old Levi's, and he's on his lunch break. And I said, bring him up, you know. And he came and shook my hand. I'm so honored to meet you. The song goes like this, you know. I told her goodbye, and I heard that, and I got teary-eyed, mm-hmm. You know. I don't cry very often. But, Bob, boy, it was just really touching to me to see a...
Bob sat over there, and he and I were both on the edge of... Why is it that kind of music?
It's simple.
Does it make you want to cry? You're
yeah, that's country music, though.
It's everyday life.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm trying to do on an album instead of doing... That's why I like your album. You're not trying to be the full contemporary, new wave stuff, or I'm going to change with this or change with that. You've got to be yourself. And you look at Bill Gaither, he's himself. And I think that's what you need to do. You need to be yourself, keep it simple. The gospel of Christ is simple. A young child can respond to the gospel of Jesus Christ. An elderly man can respond to the gospel. It's simple. And I think that music needs to be simple. I think we don't need to just say, I'm just country. I love doing classical music and other types of music, but I think that back when you were talking about Tammy Sue, what I admire about her is that she's not affected by everything. Well, my dad is Jim Bakker, you know. I was playing in a little coffee house here, and she was there with a couple of guys that were friends of hers, and she was sitting in the crowd, and I didn't know that was her, and I was picking and making jokes, and she was smiling and talked to her a little bit, and she was just real nice and humble. And then they said, well, that's Tammy Sue. And I thought, well, that's kind of neat. She's not walking around, I'm doing this big show and everything. And I think we need that in Christianity. God will bless what you say, but if your life isn't right, he's not going to bless you. He'll bless the people because we're speaking the truth. You know, like we could be talking the truth, and I could be living a horrible life. And God will bless what I say because it's true, but he's not going to bless me. And I think that's what we need to think about. And I appreciate your sincerity there. I really do. You know, I was hoping I'd ride up on a Harley Davidson and have you on the back.
If she'd have known it, she'd have been there.
Boots up here, you know. Maybe next time.
Maybe next time. I am in the midst of falling off this bale of hay
This bale of hay is falling apart.
Yes, it is.
And we are both going to end up on the floor.
I'm going to move over, and how much time do we have left?
Got 3 minutes.
3 minutes. We have 3 minutes left. Can Derek Floyd sing? No. Derek can't sing. Derek can sing tomorrow. We're going to pitch the book. Good.
We're going to. Why?
You know this white book we have.
She is honest.
I've wanted to pitch this book myself.
You haven't got the nerve.
Can we talk?
Go for it.
Can
go
we
for
talk?
It. Hack.
I am. I'm from Fort Mill, South Carolina. And I wanted to have a country show, so we did, and I'm glad.
Great.
And PTL is not in Fort Mill, South Carolina, but it's in Charlotte, North Carolina. That's our address. Please get this book. It really is a good book coming from me. That means a lot because, you know, I don't get into a lot of stuff around here. But not in a bad way. I mean, I get into the stuff here, but, you know, there's some stuff that's boring and some stuff that's fun. But this book is really fun, and you need to buy it because, you know, it's a $100 one-time gift. You don't have to be a monthly partner to get this book. It's good if you are a monthly partner, but you don't have to be. And it's Jim Bakker, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28279. And the number is 704-554-6000. And do we ever do the Canada number? No one ever does the Canada number.
Go for it.
It's 416-620-9900. That is in Canada. Yes, I knew that.
Tammy Sue, isn't it wonderful that the phones are ringing? And in case the people can't get through right now during the program, keep calling because they're ringing.
The phones are ringing even though you can't hear them. The reason why you can't hear them is because people are talking on them right now, right? Hello over there. Well, they're not real excited, but we want to thank everybody for coming on the show today with us. And make sure you go to those concerts for J&J Music because those are going to be awesomely wonderful. And make sure you watch the show tomorrow because we have the Cathedrals, and they're one of my personal favorite quartet groups.
Right.
And Philip Cameron is our seminar speaker every night this week. And then the J&J Music is all this week, too, right? Just one week.
Thursday night.
Monday through Thursday? Yes.
Yeah, Carla Worley.
And Carla Worley is tonight. She had to come in and see her. And,
You got a minute and a half, kid. I ain't going to help you at all. Sit on.
No, but I just thought I'd take over for a little while because I got bored. So I decided to do something.
Do it.
What? Oh. Yes. Make sure that you do pray for Mom. We keep saying this and keep saying it, but she really needs your prayers. And thank you for watching. Thank you for keeping up with me. And thank you for everything. Buy this book, okay? So I don't have to talk about it anymore. Thank you. Bye.
Together we can lift the world together.